North Avenue.
We're gonna wait for you guys here.
It sucks that you can't see my slash scenes in this free cam, dude. I have so many of them. It took me so long. I'm so upset about it.
Forgive me for my sins. Forgive the bonus that is to come.
Exactly.
Turn those down. There might be somebody hiding in a bush or something.
Can't see my slash scenes. I'm so upset. There's a head over here.
It's just a head.
Oh, well, it's a body part. It's the beginnings of a body.
There's more blood this way.
Ooh. There it is.
Well, no, because anyone watching the video is not going to see the slash scenes that we put.
Oh, he brought the probe.
This is just crazy with more pizzazz.
Does this look like any of the current cases you have?
Really? They all lie.
Probably
everybody lies. I lie on my taxes every April.
Silver, get the fuck out of here. You're not even LCPD. Get the fuck back to Alden.
I agree.
If they were truly creative, they probably would have spiked the fucking body on there.
No, I mean, should have piked the head.
Something like that, right? Yeah.
Was there a body?
Yeah, it's
there was a head and two hands.
So we're kind of... I like... At least they're mocking your lack of creativity. Nah, they're going to mock it when I shoot 17 cops. But anyway, yeah.
Kowalski. Is this yours?
I don't know.
Well, who's taking it?
Whatever. Doesn't really matter. I would say, though, if you're going to have a homicide, especially one that's more... I'd say...
Organized.
In this manner, you might want to have more seasoned detective. Or get.
I'm trying to help these DITs make their bones.
Why don't you get up
first?
Make their bones.
Get Everett out of here.
It's in my precinct.
Everett's on, I think. So.
Yeah. Well, Everett's a captain, though. I mean, Everett usually fucking hates it when we call him.
I'll do me a favor. I want Schultz to take the primary on this once. 6-8, so...
Shut up, mess out.
Do me a favor, Kowalski, if you can help her out with the case.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Well, you dress like it, but I didn't know that. That's crazy. Huh, you're like the last person I expected to be in the 1-0.
Do any of your cars have a computer in them?
What?
We do.
She said, do any of your cars have a computer
in them?
I'm gonna go run the name of the 911 call real fast.
Mm-hmm.
I already ran it.
You already did?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's fine. Then me and Schultz can do it, then.
Yeah, and the only thing to his name is a Seminole.
Oh, so sorry, so sorry.
That hurt.
I'm gonna go secure the perimeter.
Go for that.
Almost like a wit ritual.
Oh. Oh, you're talking about the abandoned hospital on the island?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah, no, then we're talking about the same one. Yeah.
Okay.
We're gonna go back.
Start on this. So Kowalski. So we do have a name. It's Jimmy Valentino.
We should tell.
What do you guys want done with his hands?
PSB. To look out for any reckless driving cars pulling out of the 6-8.
I got pictures of all that.
Do I want the hands? But yeah, no, I'm asking, like, do you want anything done with them? Do you want to keep them?
Oh,
paper?
Yeah, definitely bag them up and see what
yeah, well, they're already in little sandwich bags right now.
It's also my double job, so I can do that.
Yep.
Exactly. So, yeah, get them bagged up. Try and do foreign DNA swabs up. Yeah, I don't even know how to tell you. I'm telling you how to do your job. Yeah, no, you know what to do. You know.
These fucking murderers and shit. All
right, yeah, we got yeah, Juliana Valentina. Yeah. Something like that. Yeah. All right. And she's 17, I believe.
I'm down $1 million.
According to her birthday, yes.
You're down $1 million.
Okay, cool.
Dollars,
I'm just going to, you know,
hey,
send my report over to you, Cole.
What for this?
Me.
Sending it to me would be the easiest.
Fucking lazy ass fucking.
Over there? No.
I think the medical examiner's taking her.
Okay. Medical examiner already took her. They're doing their autopsy right now.
Okay.
After a roll call or not, but I got a body here. It hit cocked, nailed, look. Donald Sundance and broker. Rivera, and Kowalski if you're there. DIT, they need a case as well. Outlook, hold on. I'll put a ping for him. Fucking god.
What's wrong with you, kid? Are you first homicide?
Yes. It's high school ID next to it. It's our victim from the golf course.
Hmm?
It's an ID next to our high school ID. It's our body. Most likely our body from the,
The headless?
It is headless.
Yeah.
Female. Hands are gone.
Yeah.
And her hands, yeah.
More than likely our body.
No, there's the rest of the body.
There's a high school ID right there. And we got two notes. I'm sorry. And the voices told me, so we might have a schizophrenic.
Yeah. I'll label that on my profile, I think.
We got an EDP.
Juliana Valentino.
I want to send a squad over there to check that out. Just in case, because her high school ID was there.
The college. What's the date of birth on the... Yeah, what's the date of birth on the ID?
17.
17? She could be a freshman.
Yeah, maybe.
If she had like a late birthday.
She all late.
Detectives over there. Oh, well, no, yeah. Well, normal PD aren't going to be responding. So for those of you tuning in, this character's daughter was murdered by me, by the way. I killed her. Dismembered her. The PD have discovered her, but I'm trying to cover my tracks because they don't have any evidence on me. I'm trying to cover my tracks and, like, fucking report her missing and shit, not knowing she's dead, all that. I don't think I got the acting skills, though, to pull that off. Can we, But you know what? Let's wait up at their cars. Let's just wait up at their cars.
You living in a shithole. Oh, just a blood.
Could be. I don't know. It looks like one. Money 6 murder gang.
Hey. Excuse me, I'm the one that called 911.
Oh, you were?
Yeah, I'm trying to report my daughter missing. She hasn't been home in a few days.
What's your name, sir?
My name is Jimmy Valentino.
You have anywhere we can talk at all?
Yeah, where?
Anywhere comfortable.
Why? What's going on?
I just prefer we have a conversation with you somewhere more, less out in the open. You can sit down.
I mean, I guess over by a bench over there or something. I mean, my apartment's a mess. I don't want to go back into my home.
If you'd like to do that, we can. Sure.
Well, I mean, I don't want to do that. I guess down here, I guess. What's this about? What do you guys need to talk to me for? I called you guys here to talk to you.
Your daughter missing?
Yeah, Juliana.
Okay. All right. When was the last time you saw your daughter?
About 3 days. Something like that. I don't know. We were playing down by the water. Last time I saw her, then she was going to go hang out with a friend. Then I left to go run errands. Same with the wife. Wife's been gone for a few days, too. I don't know where the hell she is.
All right. You just want to sit down.
Okay.
I do have some unfortunate news. Okay? But,
okay.
Your daughter was found dead. All right.
What? What the... Yeah. Whoa. Fuck you. You think that's fucking funny?
No, sir. It's not a laughing matter. No, I don't.
You're fucking lying. No, you're lying. What is this, some kind of sick joke? This is how the LCPD gets their kicks? Come on.
It's not a joke. It's not a joke.
Yeah, no, sir. Unfortunately, it's not a... Your daughter was found dead late last night. The details surrounding it, you know, we're still piecing things together. We're still looking into things. It's an ongoing investigation. So anything that you might remember about her whereabouts within the last 3 days, you said, what she was doing, how she was acting, would she go places with, anything that you might think would be pertinent to that?
I don't know. Juliana, she's dead?
Yes, sir.
Oh, no. What happened?
Like I said, I can't go too...
No, you can tell me.
Too much
tell me
into
what
the
happened
details.
To my daughter. Tell me what happened to my daughter, please.
But we don't know exactly what happened with your daughter, sir, so we're trying to piece that all together.
How do you mean you don't know? You're the police. You're supposed to fucking know.
We're supposed to investigate it, which is what we're trying. So if there's anything that you might know or remember about your daughter's whereabouts and movements in the last 3 days, last week...
I don't know shit.
Fucking A.
Jeez. Where was she? You tell me, at least tell me where my daughter was when you found her. You at least tell me that, please. Please.
We,
at least tell me
she
that.
She was found deceased. She was found deceased out in, Hove Beach. Is that an area that she frequents at all?
No, she goes to school in Meadow Park.
Okay.
Trying to put her up at a nicer school. She was around this shit in this bullshit area. What you mean she's dead? You're fucking lying.
I'm not lying, sir.
Oh, no. God, no. Fuck. What am I gonna tell the fucking mother? Speaking of, too, I haven't seen her in a long time. I haven't seen her in a week.
She on a business trip at all, or did she just walk out one day?
Oh, man, I don't know. Me and her don't get along anyway. We're in the process for divorce.
Okay.
Fucking A.
Do you know anybody that would want to hurt your daughter?
No, who the fuck would want to hurt her? I don't know why anyone would want to hurt her. You know? Oh, shit.
Was Juliana involved with anybody romantically? Did she have a boyfriend? Anything like that?
No. No, she wasn't involved with anybody. Not that I know of.
Jesus. Can you recollect the last time you interacted with your daughter?
Just give me a second to collect my thoughts and calm down, okay?
Of course. Take your time. I know it's,
I'm just like, I ain't gonna get away. I'm doing that voice. That you're getting. Me and my daughter moved down here with my wife from Mass, from North Attleboro, Massachusetts. Moved down here to LC a few years ago for work. And I don't know, she never liked the move. She was never a fan of it. She didn't like it here. Always wanted to leave. Sorry, I'm at a loss for fucking words. I don't know. I can't think.
I understand.
Do you guys have any clues? I mean, was she, like, hit by a car? Like...
We do believe that there were signs of foul play.
Foul play.
So anything that you...
What does that mean, foul play?
That, she lost her life maliciously, on purpose. There were other factors involved.
What, so maliciously on purpose? What you mean, she killed herself? No.
Not saying that, but there were outside forces involved with her her death.
I mean, I knew she was depressed, but not suicide. Come on. Okay.
The last interaction you had with your daughter... You said it was 3 days ago, right?
Yeah, we were fighting.
Fighting? What were you guys fighting about?
Grades. School.
The grades.
C's and D's. You know, fatherly shit. You know.
Mm-hmm. And where did that take place?
In my apartment.
All right.
You know, just up there in my apartment. But then after that, I mean... She stole him out of the house to go hang out with a friend. And, I don't know, she never checked in. I figured give it a few days. She's a teenager, you know, she always hangs out with a friend. So I thought nothing of it.
Did she say what friend she was going to go and hang out with? Go and spend the night?
My friend Mary.
Mary? Do you know her last name?
No, I can't remember that shit. She
goes,
you know,
it's where a she stays at?
It's somewhere near Meadow Park.
Meadow Park.
Oh, her mom always set that shit up. I don't know. I only get custody on weekends. But I don't know.
Did your daughter ever express to you any sort of concerns at all about her safety? Anything like that?
I don't know. I'm just all confused. Right. Was this a suicide? What was it? You keep saying, like, what was it? How did you find my daughter?
We don't believe it was a suicide. Like I said, I can't divulge the full details at the moment because it's an ongoing investigation.
Can't divulge details to me? It's my fucking daughter.
I understand that, but I would rather spare you the pain of hearing the details. They're rather grim.
I have a right to know them.
You do. However, at this time, I'm not going to tell them to you. Okay? And that's just because, again, the entire investigation is ongoing. We're still looking into things.
Chad, I'm intentionally trying not to say the word murder. Like, I'm trying not to say the word murder.
Anything that you can remember at all? Anything that you might think might be pertinent?
Oh, man, we had a fight. She left the house, and she was going to go over to Mary's. Gave it the weekend. Didn't hear from her. Figured I'd call you guys. When did you find her? I want to know when you found her. How long ago?
Schultz, do you recall?
Approximately 2 hours ago. 2.5 hours.
Two hours ago.
Yeah.
Where? I ain't gonna smirk at shit.
In Hove Beach.
Where is she? Where is she now? Where is she now?
So her body was morgue. All right, I believe. I think it's North Holland, so just a couple blocks from here. Actually, right across the street. But her body was taken there. An autopsy is being performed. A toxicology test is being performed, and all that. And hopefully, that'll show us a few more answers that we might not have at the moment. But from there, once the autopsy is complete, everything is
can I see her?
Situated. I don't know what the policy is for the medical examiner's office. Usually, we'll have somebody identify the body physically if we don't have any positive identification. But I think at the moment we do. So I don't know if they're gonna have you identify the body or whatnot, but. They are going to more than likely get a hold of you, or if you want to go down there yourself and get a hold of one of the medical examiners, and whenever they're done on their end, you can take custody of the body. The hospital, they'll figure out the arrangements, whether or not it gets transported to a funeral home, if you want her body cremated, whatever you plan to do, that's all up to you, whatever you had in mind.
Gotta try to find a mom. Talk to her mother. I don't know where she's at, but I'll find her.
Okay. All right.
What's your wife's name?
My wife's name? Sarah.
And you two are married, so Valentino, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if she has a record or not. She doesn't have a driver's license or anything, so I don't know if she has a record, but...
CH1.
I haven't seen her in like 5 or 6 days.
Did she say where she was going?
No, but I mean, I don't see her all the time. In the process of the divorce, she stays at her mom's place or something.
Where's her mom's place located?
They moved. It used to be in Hove Beach. But, no, now it's somewhere in Albany.
Okay.
But her mom lives in Albany. But I don't know. Like I said, we're in the process of a divorce. I don't talk to her. So I don't know where she's been, and I could care less. But, Jesus. Detectives, I need to go. I need to go and think. Am I free to leave right now, gentlemen? And ma'am?
Yeah, you're free to leave.
All right.
I'm very sorry for your loss, sir. If you have any other questions or if you can think of anything at all, I'm Detective Kowalski. Over here is Detective Schultz, Detective Rivera, and Detective Reddington. You can get a hold of us with any precinct.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to see if they're saying anything.
Hmm? Might as well. Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of this shitbox, Vic.
But, couple things. Here, I'll meet you at the 2-3. Actually, let's meet you, up the block. Oh, or not. Never mind, fuck it. So, couple things I noticed.
He never made eye contact except once.
Never made eye contact. There's an argument. But details of that argument we'll have to look into a little bit further. Another thing I noticed was earlier he said that they were down by the water, then the last interaction was in the apartment. So I don't know how that changed. Yeah.
Divorced with his wife. The wife lives in Alderney. No driver's license, last seen a week ago. Les states that he saw his daughter 3 days ago. They had a fight in their apartment. She went to go see.
All right.
Fuck.
Who are you taking left?
Gloves. Everyone.
Two of you. Everyone glove up. Everyone glove up. Everyone glove up.
Hey. No one's. Do you guys? You guys can unholster. This is it. They're not on scene.
What the fuck is this?
Yes, you were better.
Oh my god.
Holy fucking shit. And it's fucking school IP, man.
School ID.
Yeah. Nope. Forward. Go. You're not gonna make it. Yeah. Okay. Now come back. Straight back. Right down left. Straight back down left. There you go. Yeah. There you go.
This is more than two fucking corpses. If there's this much jib all over the ground. Fuck.
Knew it.
Fuck.
What is he targeting? Fucking high school girl?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Mary is the friend of Juliana.
Yeah, I know her last name. I've been. Okay, that's all. Fuck.
Two ways they go through here. Over there, and there.
All right, we'll just make sure they are secure then.
Yeah, I'll tell this officer here that you guys are going to hear.
There's an ID staple to this corpse.
Got no over here. God knows why.
Sarah Valentino. This is the
Sarah
wife.
Sarah Valentino.
The wife? At least now it's the idea of the wife. I'm not sure if it is the wife.
Fuck.
God knows why.
Is it by chance this?
Is this teeth over here?
They definitely found it. Ski Bear, thanks for the follow button.
Hey, Kowalski.
Yeah?
You won't believe it, we got teeth and pliers.
What?
Yeah, look over here.
Yeah, three teeth and a pair of pliers.
Who do those belong to? You can take the fingerprints on the pliers?
I don't want to touch it.
You guys want us to run dental records? Well, after.
Yeah, good.
Yeah. I could do that, yeah.
Shit. Okay, we should, let me take some pictures. We'll get the examiners to take the bodies.
This whole scene's kind of fucked.
Yeah,
Now we got a fucking serial killer out there roaming the streets of Liberty. Great. Fucking great.
Kids, man, they fucking kill the kids, man.
So what you gotta do when you find the fucker? And you're all alone with him.
Hey, hey, if I don't fucking say, fucking chop his fucking... Fucking shoot him to hell.
Oh, now my screenshots work. Nah, man, you guys got no idea, man. If we get access to that fucking object menu, it's over for everybody.
It's reached to the fence of the harbor. Yes, there's chunks everywhere. There's there's two bodies right now. Yeah, I would advise Dunn. I see you. Oh, I didn't even know that. Yeah, well, the detectives are looking into it. OCME is also here, so. Alright. Yep.
There's a pipe wrench. I didn't even see that big ass pipe wrench.
Yeah, I already bagged it. You see, we get a written statement from the guy? Let's see if the handwriting matches.
Yeah, we can do that. So, the only person that should have known where Bennett was, besides the father, is also dead. So, need a handwriting sample. Let's get him into questioning.
He was missing for, a week?
A week. We should also, if the coroner, if we can get a date on this body, roughly how long it's been deceased.
I'm gonna say, man.
Which one?
That's true.
Both of them.
Both.
All right.
Yeah. I guess it's sort of timeline.
Amen.
So, let's get a handwriting sample. If we want to, we can get him into. If I can find him, we can get him into questioning. I'd also like to get a. Let's see. I would also like to get a picture of his tread on his car. To see if that matches our ones at the scene of the golf course, and then...
Oh my god, sorry.
I would also like to see if you would let us... Or let our forensics team take a look at his car for any evidence of blood.
This for YouTube? Oh, hell yeah, bro.
You forensics?
We might need a warrant for that.
Need a warrant? Well, if he consents to it, no?
I mean... The tread's messing, and we get his handwriting to give us probably a possible one. But... And this, possibly.
What are we talking about? Evidence?
Hmm? We also got we can print these tools too. If they come back.
Yeah.
I would take the evidence if I had the right van for it, but right now I'm doing other things.
Yeah, no, you're good.
Well.
I wasn't wearing gloves when we talked.
I see.
Where are these two dildos going?
Yeah! Okay, bro. I need to...
Ah, fuck. Ah.
What?
That's not recording.
Sorry, my pain. It's fine. No. Yeah, no, we already have officers just... security area and just patrolling around since this is a big area. It counts as light duty, at least I'm not gonna stand on the desk for it, bro.
What was I say, man? I love doing this shit. Setting shit up and watching how other people react to it. I would fucking love it. I don't know about you guys. It's chef's kiss.
See if they were friends or, you know.
Where'd he try going there? Nothing.
Not really. Totally unrelated.
Sorry about that. No, you're good.
Again.
I see a certain redhead coming here. Is that fucking major case?
What, 29 medals?
Yep.
Now, Lindsay's.
Okay. Thank God.
Brunette. Sexy.
Oh.
Whitman's dick. Oh. Ridiculous.
Alright.
Running out of female employees. Female co-workers to sexually harass. Ridiculous.
Alright, y'all should be good thing?
Oh, I said, well, I'm not getting sexually harassed, because he's my fiancé, so...
Oh, well, there you go.
Yep. Quite the art project.
Indeed. Like all the blood?
I do.
An absorbent amount.
Mm-hmm.
It is a shame that they see the jet thing that was supposed to be deleted,
yeah.
So they see way more blood than they're supposed to be seeing.
Like a sponge?
Yeah, I really don't know what that word means, I'll be real.
I mean exuberant. Exuberant. My fault.
What did I miss?
Oh, fuck.
What?
I think it's safe to say that they spotted me and that I should leave the area immediately. Oh, God. I got one better. Hold on. If that was actually a detective car, I would have shit myself laughing. Stamina to get across this whole bridge. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Mr. Valentino!
Yeah?
What's going on? Funny seeing you here.
Yeah, what's up? Can I help you, detectives, with?
You know, we were just gonna go pay a little visit to the house.
Oh, yeah? What for?
We just wanna...
What's going on down there? I was out for a walk, going over to Broker to get some bread from the deli, and I saw the cop lights by the station.
Oh, yeah. You know how it is. It's Bohan. High crime area. You wouldn't mind coming down to the station answering some questions for us, would you?
Sure, boys. Yeah.
Alright.
Down to the station. No problem.
You don't mind? You have a car? Oh, no, I'm sure you don't have a car at the moment.
I mean, it's parked over by the apartments down there, but, I mean, I got one.
You can ride
sure.
with me.
How about, you know what,
to.
You can... We'll give you a ride back to the apartment. You know, you, just come on down to the 47th Precinct in Bohan, all right?
Yeah, no problem.
All right.
Here, my ride.
Hey, McMillan.
What's up,
hey, you can ride in that blue. McMillan, can you give Mr. Valentino here a ride to his apartment?
Yeah, I still got that gun on me, but I'm gonna play it. Don't worry. Who am I going with? This blue car here?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, they're taking me downtown. I'm pre-calling it right now.
What's
I'm going
that?
Downtown, boys. What was going on back down there?
Oh, nothing much, you know, just another scene.
Yeah, but
we're just wrapping up, actually.
Death diving in the water would have been dog shit. You know what I mean? I just going to jail for 20. Hey, bro, they can't
How
prove
you doing
I was
anyways?
Involved.
You're doing all right?
I lost my daughter recently, and I don't know where my wife is, so I'm not doing very good, to be blunt with you, sir.
No, I understand. I figured I'd ask
224 to his apartment. What's up?
None of these ones. It's this apartment complex here, this high-rise one.
Oh, the projects, okay.
Yeah, yeah, right here in the projects. So that my car is parked around the corner.
Yeah, he's gonna... Mm. One old base, he's getting his vehicle.
All right.
Yeah, we'll drop you off here, and you just get in your car. We'll meet you back there, all right?
So where am I going? The 10th precinct, or am I going 46? Where am I going here?
The
47,
yeah.
The 47 precinct, okay?
I'll
give you the location.
The one in Northern Gardens?
Northern Gardens,
Northern Gardens at Leavenworth.
Okay, I'll let me get my car, and I'll meet you guys there.
All right.
Oh, bro, they're watching me, bro. Hey, y'all ready for me to get interrogated? Are y'all ready? Jimmy Valentino, I was told to come here by detectives.
You know what detectives called you down here?
I didn't catch their names, gonna be honest.
Alright. Just wait behind the white line, I'll be right. Alright, come on. Let's go. You have any weapons or anything on you? Shouldn't I have?
No, sir, I don't.
Alright, I'll take your word for it. Not getting fricked with anything. Hey guys, here's your guy.
Hello.
Hey, Rivera, door. Can you go do that
Mr.
thing?
Mr. Valentino, you mind just coming with us real quick?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Sit down and talk. Okay, just do me a favor. We're gonna just talk in here real quick. I'll be right with you. Alright, just sit to the chair right to your right, alright?
Okay.
Need anything at all before I leave? Any food, water, anything to drink?
No, detective. I'm fine.
Okay. Alright. I'll be right back with you.
Do you think this is where they molest me, chat? That's mean to do. We just turned the heat up in the room.
Yeah, fuck the Red Sox.
Nah, bro. I should have. I'm cooked.
Roughly 3 hours ago now. Do we want to wait for the other two? Or just the one? In hands. Okay. Got tire marks at the car at the scene. Rivera's looking for the car, see if we can get a picture of his tires. Yeah, I think that's what he's doing right now.
It's out there.
So that's the only connection we have to that one. Next thing is we find that body over in Broker. It's his daughter. And then we go and question him. He calls the police asking them to report him. We go and talk to him. He never makes eye contact except once.
He could be autistic.
Thanks, no. Dude. Fucking A.
I mean, I'm not trying to discount that. I mean, it could be a reason why. This guy, if he is our killer, he's emotionally disturbed heavily. To cut off your own daughter's head and feet and the dismember your own daughter's.
Whatever
the daughter did had to be worse than the wife.
Right. Is if we get a written confession with him, and it doesn't, match up with any sort of the writing patterns.
Oh yeah,
the
handwriting. Notes.
The notes.
Which I mean, isn't that common to try and like make your handwriting look a little shittier?
And do we need a warrant for that or no?
But no, not at all. If he signs it, he signs it.
I got you.
A multiple personality disorder. Mm-hmm. Handwriting can change.
So the main thing we want here is answers, as in where you were. More information on the relationship between him and his wife and him and his daughter. What exactly they were arguing about. You know what I mean? Ask him again about when the last time they saw her, see if the answers line up again. You know, try to go over again what we talked to him about at his house, you know. See if they stay the same.
Fucking case and just be like, ah, oh, well, here's, I'm gonna do it and you guys are gonna watch.
Oh, like I said, well, no, we're DITs, yeah. So, I mean, we can step in, but I think...
No. I would actually prefer you guys are more oriented towards, you know, maybe we can all take turns on them. Not like that, but you know what I mean? We can all, like, take turns
in interviewing them. They're gonna tag
really
team me, Chad.
That.
If you want to start us off...
I'll... Guys.
How's it going?
I mean, I'm here in a room and I've been sitting here for a while and I'd like to know why.
We apologize for the wait.
So, what's this about?
Alright, first I'm gonna read your rights, Mr. Jimmy Valentino. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of law. You have the right to attorney. Now, phone won't be appointed to you by the State of Liberty.
Okay.
Any point in time, you can refuse to request a lawyer. You understand that?
Yeah, I understand.
All right, with these rights in mind, you wish to speak to us?
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. Detective Rivera, after my right is Detective Kowalski in front of me. Who am I speaking with?
Are you asking me my name?
Yeah, state your name for the record, please, sir.
Jimmy Valentino, sir.
Jimmy Valentino, case number 182802. Current date is June 13th, 1996. 10:12 EST PM.
Listen, pal, I got no idea what you're saying.
All right, your story again about when the last time you seen your daughter.
Last time I saw my daughter, about 3 days ago, we had a fight regarding her grades. She took off to be with a friend, Mary. I hadn't seen her, figured it was the weekend. She was spending the night like she does all the time. Then I called the police to report my daughter lost after I didn't hear from her.
And how long was that until you made that a call for the police?
2 days, 3 days.
When did your concern arisen?
Sorry, can you speak up,
your
sir?
Daughter's? When did you become concerned of your daughter's safety? Like when you thought about, hey, well, I wonder where she was.
Well, I knew where she was. She said she was with her friend Mary. She spends all of her damn time over there with that woman. That's all she does. She spends all of her time over there hanging out with her. They're best friends. So you know what? I figured, hey, no big deal. It was a Friday, then a Saturday, then a Sunday, and then it was a Monday. And I'm like, she's supposed to be at school. I don't know where she is. She hasn't been around all weekend. I'm going to report this. It's that simple.
Did she tell you she was staying there the whole weekend?
No, but she was mad at me. So I figured, what the fuck? If she's being a moody bitch, her mom could deal with her.
At any point in time, did you try to contact the mother in regards to her grades or anything like that?
No. I did not.
Did she take her bag with her?
Fuck.
You hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. No, she took no bags.
So is she with the stay at her friends for 3 days with no clothing?
She's kind of weird.
Will you consider your daughter a good hygiene individual?
I'm sorry, what? A good hygiene individual? Or am I hearing that?
Does she have good hygiene?
Generally?
Consider her, like, not really?
No, I said generally she does. But when someone's angry, they're gonna do shit on an impulse, like take off randomly, without packing things. Plus, I work during the day. Okay? She could have come back. She's a key to my apartment. And I don't go in her room. She's 17. I don't need to know what's in her fucking room. I know why he's asking that, Jay. I know why he's asking me that. She did not take a bag that I know of. She's got a lot of fucking bags. Maybe she got clothes from her mother's house. How the hell would I know?
Alright, let's go back to what she was missing. You called the cops.
Yes.
Did you, at any point in time, go in her room, see if anything's missing, determine if she ran away?
No.
So you just left the...
She's only with me on weekends. She's with her mother a majority of the time. The only clothing and bags she has at my house are spare things, so main things are at her mother's house. So I think it's reasonable for me to assume that if she needed clothing, she would have contacted her mother, or at least would have gone over to her mother's house, not mine. She doesn't have shit at my house.
Your car. I notice every time we've seen you, you're walking.
Around the back by the cul-de-sac.
Around the back by the cul-de-sac?
Mm-hmm. Right by that apartment complex down there. For the exact reason that I had a good feeling that y'all fuckers were going to unlawfully search my car. So I wanted to park away where you vultures couldn't try to pick through my car. Because I have a good feeling that when a group of detectives ask me to come down somewhere, it's for a reason.
We're just trying to get all angles of the investigation, that's all.
All angles of the investigation. Is that why they left to go down there to my car?
No one's at your car.
Yeah, well, I don't give no consent for anyone to go in my car.
The reason for that, Mr. Valentino?
Because I don't want anyone going into my personal property. This is the United States. And why am I here?
It's just a standard thing that we usually do. Obviously, we have to follow up on every lead that we get.
Well, yeah,
especially
speaking
during
of,
an investigation
speaking
like
of,
this.
Speaking of, then. Speaking of, because I want to see if you fuckers did your job. Did you ever find out what happened to my daughter? You find her dead, no reason? You guys ever find out why? What happened to her?
If we did, we wouldn't be in the situation that we're in right now, Mr. Valentino.
You can't look at her body and think, oh, maybe she was hit by a car, she was shot, she was stabbed. Like, you can't figure that out at least?
We know all that.
And you won't tell me?
Again, as a father, I would assume you wouldn't want to hear the grim details surrounding your daughter's death.
No, I do, actually. It's my right to know.
I'll be more than happy to provide an autopsy report for you if you'd like.
Uh-huh. Any more questions, gentlemen?
No, what are your hobbies?
A few more.
Ridiculous.
I lose my daughter and I'm being dragged station to station to talk to cop.
Yeah, that's about it.
I think I might take an approach about setting up a timeline. That's what I want to get from him, is a timeline.
All fine and dandy, whatever approach you guys want to use. If you guys see something that might not add up, doesn't sound right, use it to your advantage. Yada, yada.
Yeah, let's get him talking.
I just edited it for my plan to work, so...
Yeah. Remember, you don't want to get him agitated unless you're absolutely sure about something or if you have a plan for it down the line, too.
Yep.
Especially in this case scenario, since we have three people kind of just interviewing the guy. Everybody might want to try a different approach. Might fuck him up. I don't know. We'll find out. Either way, I see it going very well. Remember, you are in
GSC
control.
GSC top
at
shot,
all
by
times.
The way. Thanks for the follow button. Head down in the chat, bro.
And being in control also kind of means that sometimes you gotta make it seem like he's in control. You get what I mean?
Yep.
Alright, cool. Alright, go get him, Tiger. Go kill him. Don't kill him, but you know what I mean? I mean,
yeah.
What can I help you with, man?
Alright, I'm Detective Loretta Schultz. Alright, I'm gonna ask you a few questions, okay? About your whereabouts. Sound good to you?
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good to me. Alright, so obviously, it's very tragic. You know, what happened to your daughter? My heart goes out to you, alright, man? I know that's probably real hard to go through, alright?
I mean, yeah, when it technically did. Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, I want to talk a bit more about this argument, okay? With your daughter.
Okay.
So you stated that you were arguing over, you know, the mom or having some problems with the mom. I know you're going through a divorce, right?
Had nothing to do with, well, I mean, I guess subjectively maybe, but that's not the reason me and my daughter were fighting.
Okay. What was the reason? If you don't mind me asking.
It was over her grades. She's been getting C's and D's lately at high school, and I put a lot of money to get her up into a nicer high school. We're not even in that district, technically, so she's lucky she's able to go.
I gotcha. So about these grades. So, she got angry, and he stated that she went to her friends, Mary. Mm-hmm. You said you know her last name?
Bennett.
Bennett?
Mary Bennett, yeah.
Okay. When's the last time you saw Miss Bennett?
Define saw.
Seen her.
Just seen her or interacted with
her? Yeah, just seen her, talked to her.
I see her all the time whenever I'd pick my daughter up from high school, but that doesn't mean I interacted with her. The last time I interacted with her was maybe, I don't know, a month or two ago.
A month or two ago?
Yeah, maybe.
So you said you had this argument on a Friday, correct? You know, and that's why you didn't call us until now, because it's over the weekend.
Yeah, it was Friday after she got home from school.
Okay. You said she's been missing for about 2-3 days?
I mean, Saturday and Sunday for sure. I guess you found them on a Monday or whenever you found her. So Friday, mm-hmm. Halfway through the day, so yeah, about 2.5 days. I wouldn't say 3 full days, but you know.
I got you. When's the last time you talked to your wife?
Week ago. Two weeks ago. She doesn't talk to me. She doesn't want to.
2 weeks ago? I can ask you some questions about your situation with your wife.
Go ahead.
Alright. So you said did she file divorce or did you file for divorce?
She filed for divorce.
Was there a reason?
Unhappy in her marriage.
Unhappy?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think the reason is?
Don't know. You'd have to ask her.
I would if I could. Okay.
Oh, hold on.
Kowalski?
What do you mean, if you could?
Kowalski, me to step up for a second. We'll talk in a second, right?
What the fuck did you mean by, yeah, you would if you could?
Mr. Valentino. You said your daughter was with Mary for 3 days, correct?
To my knowledge, yes.
Okay. Is that typical for her to just kind of vanish a couple days at a time?
Yeah, they do it all the time.
Hmm.
It's actually my opinion that they may have been a little more than friends, if I'm being brutally honest.
All right. Your wife.
Mm-hmm.
What was the last interaction you had with her?
She was dropping off Juliana, and that's it. Professional formality. Yep, professional formalities for her sake.
And that's it. What was the last argument you had with her?
Last argument is ever on the phone. Maybe a week and a half ago.
Typical, what was it about?
Typical angry shit. Fuck you. I'm gonna take your house. You're never gonna see your daughter. Fuck you, you prick, piece of shit, asshole, son of a bitch, ungrateful, guinea fuck. You know, things like that.
Guinea fuck. Is your wife not Italian?
She's Irish.
Irish, oh. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, I am too.
Sounds like a real piece of work she was.
Yeah, well. A woman isn't, huh?
I suppose so.
Mm. Are you married?
I was.
And what happened there?
My wife passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Did you love your wife?
Dearly, we were high school sweethearts.
Isn't that cute?
Yeah.
Where are you going with all of it, detective?
Your wife was murdered. Found her dead.
My wife was murdered too. So let me get this straight. My ex-wife, excuse me, was murdered. My daughter.
Well, I mean, still wife, right? The divorce isn't final.
Well, might as well have been final. My daughter, who you still haven't told me what happened, whether that was suicide, homicide, accident, you guys are still yet to tell me that.
When we use the term foul play, we're referring to more than likely it was a homicide.
So if you know it's just more than likely that my daughter was killed, but you know for a fact my wife was, how did you determine the differences, detective?
Like I said, I can provide you an autopsy report, but I would rather, for your sake, not go into the details of what your daughter was inflicted
upon. Did you ever have kids?
We don't want to...
You have kids?
No, I never got the chance to have kids with my wife.
You never got the chance to?
No.
Oh. Never got to know what it felt like? Or to show you a pregnancy test? That excitement that you felt? Right in the deep pit of your heart? Knowing that life is going to come from something you two did, and you're about to be a dad and raise a kid and do everything better than your parents did? You never knew that feeling, did you? You never knew that, or what it felt like. You never knew. You never got to hold a newborn baby in your arms, watch that kid grow up, and then get told by some fucker with a mustache and a stupid tie that she was fucking found dead? Yeah. But you don't know what that band-aid feels like. So spare me if I'm not in a good mood.
I understand you might be upset at the news.
Upset? My wife made her choices. She made my life a living hell. I still didn't want her to die or anything like that. But excuse me if I don't shed any crocodile tears for my bitch of a wife. But I love my daughter to death. And I would have died for that little girl. For my little girl, I would have died. But instead, here I sit. I'm assuming being accused of something.
Well, you see how it looks. Your daughter gets murdered, then your wife,
oh, yeah.
Ex-wife.
Typical dad did it. Typical dad did it.
Not saying you did it. But obviously, you see how it looks.
I see how
Mary was also found dead. Right beside her.
Jesus.
Yeah.
She's a good kid, that Mary.
I don't doubt it. But you see how this looks, though. Right, Jimmy? First your wife, or your daughter, then your wife, then your daughter's friend. You know, honestly, don't mind me bringing this up, I mean, you do kind of benefit from her being in the state that she's in right now. I mean, you said the divorce wasn't final.
What'd you just say to me?
The divorce wasn't
finalized, right?
Did you
just imply to me that I'm in a better place because my wife, daughter, and daughter's friend are dead? Are you trying to imply that I'm some sick fuck? That it relishes in the fact that they are gone from this earth, sir? Is that what you're telling me?
Didn't say that at all.
You didn't say it at all.
If you'd like to take what I said in that manner, then so be it.
Oh, so it's my interpretation.
Clearly it is your interpretation, because that's not what I said, and you're interpreting what I said in that manner.
Couldn't you interpret that I'm just typical suspect because I'm the dad and that's it? And that this is Liberty City? One of the most dangerous cities on the fucking planet. Little
right.
Beautiful girls.
A lot of random crime.
Around the age of my daughter get kidnapped and worse.
All of them knowing
every
each other.
Day.
It's a big city.
Yeah.
Millions of people live here. What are the odds that three people that knew each other fairly intimately, or at least had an intimate relationship with one another, by proxy or not, all show up dead within a matter of days?
Sounds like somebody really hates my wife. I don't know. She fucked around plenty with other men. Maybe she made an enemy.
Yeah.
And on top of that, all of this sounds circumstantial as far as my person is concerned. I gave you my story and I have an alibi.
Can anybody confirm your alibi? Over the weekend, the last couple days, the week?
Yeah, maybe. Part of your mind. Stack Up Gaming, thanks for the follow.
Buddy of yours.
Yeah, but I don't know if I want him involved in this, and until I'm under arrest, I'd rather not. You're lucky, by the way. You're lucky that I'm choosing to even talk to your ass. I could say I want a lawyer, and if I'm not under arrest, I want to leave. But I'm still sitting here putting up with this shit in hopes of not going to prison for an act I didn't commit.
Well, you are free to leave at any point. You're here on your own volition right now, Mr. Valentino.
Am I?
I do want to make that clear.
Am I? Okay. Well, anyway, detective, continue, because I want to...
You don't talk about your wife very fondly, but when I brought up the fact that, technically, divorce never gets finalized, she's not around anymore, you don't lose her. You benefit from it. Plenty of motive.
I want to point out something, by the way.
Huh.
She didn't have no life insurance. There was nothing crazy like that, by the way. So if you're thinking that I killed my wife to get money out of it, I sure as hell did not.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, then what are you
trying
to say?
That'd be for a different reason.
Are you trying to get something out of me?
I'm not saying that you killed your wife, Jimmy. I'm just saying that looks awfully suspicious, right? And you're saying you were here. You're saying you were there. Earlier, you told me that you saw your... daughter by the water, and then you changed your story and told me that last time you saw your daughter, she was at the apartment. What went wrong there?
Wait. When did I ever say that I saw my daughter down by the water?
When we first talked outside of the apartment.
I don't recall ever making that statement, sir.
Well, you
down
recall...
Down by the
you don't recall
water?
Making the statement?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell me the full statement that I said? Because I don't really recall. I got a lot
you said
of things
that
on
you
my mind.
And your water, you and your daughter were down by the water. That was the last time you saw her. You guys went out, had a fun time.
No, see, I never said that, detective. I know
no,
I never
what'd you say?
Said that.
Now you recollect some.
I never said that. I never said I had a good time with her down by the water. See, you think I'm stupid? You're trying to make me
so
fumble
you say,
my
then?
Story. It
what'd
wasn't
you say, then,
that. Maybe? We had a fight.
It wasn't that.
over our grades. Her grades, excuse me. Because she's been getting season fucking D's. We were fighting about that. The last time I saw her was when she stormed out of my place, pissed off, not having no fun dandy skip session down by the waterfront. You're trying to see if I remember my story. Because if I didn't, it's possibly, or excuse me, possible. See, I'm stripping over my own fucking words here because I got cotton mouth. Because I've been sitting in this hot-ass fucking room, by the way. I'm sweating like a pig in here. It's like someone turned on the heat or something, like a prick. Now, anyway, if you'll excuse my dry fucking mouth that hurts to swallow because of cotton fucking mouth, I never said I had a fun time with her by the waterfront. You are trying to see if there's cracks or holes in my story because if I was lying, it's very hard to keep a story straight. Am I wrong, detective, or is that exactly what you're trying to do? Because I have a feeling that's what you're trying to do, and you're going to have to try a lot harder than that.
Not what I'm trying to do at all.
Mm.
You like the gays, Mr. Valentino? You a fan of them?
Hey, man. It's 1996. The fucking pillow biters everywhere. It is what it is.
It is what it is. Sounds a little bit more complacent than welcoming.
Whether I like it or not, it's not my business. People stick to their
own. You mentioned earlier
own.
That you had suspicions that your daughter and Mary were more than just friends.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that?
My daughter's happy, she's happy. Something you would have never known about. But making your kids happy makes you change. It makes you look past your selfish, narrow-minded views sometimes.
I'm sure it does.
I may not be a huge fan of them, but it doesn't matter. If my daughter's happy, so be it. I can turn the other cheek on that. I know what he's doing, Chad. I know what he's doing. You guys may not be tracking as well as I am because it's the story I set up, but I mean, I see what he's doing. It's good. It's good. Yeah. I can look past things like that. It doesn't matter to me. Whatever. She wants to go fucking have scissor fights with a friend, so be it. I don't care. As long as she's not doing drugs.
I don't know.
You're just gonna sit there and stare at me?
Not at all. You also mentioned earlier that your daughter seemed to be depressed.
Yeah, she's been depressed. She's a moody 17-year-old teenage girl. Figured it would pass. You know, sooner or later.
Did she ever seek any help about it?
She didn't want any help with it. But I didn't catch any cuts or anything like that. So I figured, hey, she's just sad. She'll get over it. She's, as long as she's not cutting herself or any of that crazy shit that I hear on the news. No, I know why he asked my opinion on homosexuals, man. He's trying to find a motive as to why I may
murder
them.
Did you offer to take her? To get help?
Yeah. At least on two separate occasions. I am actually making this story kind of hard for even me to track.
Did she...
That's why I'm...
Take you up on that? Was she receptive at all?
She said she was fine and she just didn't want to go through counseling anymore. You know, my daughter, by the way, she's adopted.
Is she?
Mm-hmm. Juliana was adopted from an orphanage.
You want?
Well, why the fuck am I talking to you? Truth be told, the first time me and my wife attempted for a child, she got 8 months in, there was no heartbeat, they had to remove the child. After about 6 months to a year-ish, I don't know, it was a blurry time and a lot of alcohol in that time of my life, we ended up adopting a girl to fill that void. And that's how we got our daughter. And now she's gone. My wife became very bitter and cold towards me. But I actually met her in high school too. We weren't sweethearts. She didn't notice me until a year after high school. But when she did, oh, we fell for each other. But let me tell you, nothing lasts. My apologies. I'm back. Now, anyway, yeah, I want to know what happened. I want to know what happened to my wife and Mary, too. But I want to know about my daughter more than anyone else, because I care about my daughter more than anybody else.
Mm-hmm.
I'm alone in this world. I don't have my family now, or my daughter, and I want to know what happened. And that's my fucking business as to why. And also, what happened to the other two detectives? How come you're in here by yourself, but the others had to have you in here? Why is that? Are they new? Are they using me as some fucking training exercise?
Not at all.
Not at all. Not at all.
Several detectives were the ones who responded to the scenes of the murders. Several detectives did their own investigative work, working as a team. Right? Teamwork makes the dream work.
Yeah, does it?
Yeah, I think so. There's no I in team.
I want to ask you a question.
Hmm.
You ever killed anybody?
In what way?
There's only one way, isn't there?
Intentionally?
Sure.
No. Why?
I got an angle I'm doing stack up. I got you. Just curious, I guess. You sit there again with your badge and your gun. Do you feel big?
You seem to have a thing against the police.
They have me locked in a room.
You're not locked in a room at all.
Accusing me of murdering my daughter. My own fucking daughter, by the way. My wife, and I'm assuming a friend. So I'm assuming, who's your prime suspect? Let me guess, it's me, huh? Answer my question.
We're just dotting our I's, crossing our T's, Mr. Valentino.
Answer my
question.
All
we're doing...
Am I your prime suspect?
Is following up the leads.
Am I your prime suspect?
I'm not gonna answer that.
You're not gonna answer it. You already just did. So I am your primary suspect, and you know what? If you were good at your fucking job whatsoever, you would be out there looking for the man that killed my family, and instead you're locked in a room with me, you piece of shit.
Investigations like this take time, Mr. Valentino. I understand that you're upset at the moment and probably a lot to process. However, we have to do our due diligence.
Shut up, Tango Gaylord.
Make sure that every lead is followed
up. Nah,
I'm
on this shit. Yeah, well, if you
we
want
to
find
the exact same
that.
Goal.
Yeah, do you?
Yeah, I do. And the only way we're going to find that is if you help us. So, again, anything that you can think of. Anything. Names, locations.
I don't know.
Signs, tells, anything that you can think of at all.
I don't know.
We need to know.
This is your job. You're the police. You're a detective. Ain't this your fucking job to find who did it? Or is this going to be another unsolved murder for the LCPD?
Would you mind if a detective or a team of detectives goes through your daughter's room at your home?
Maybe.
You do mind? Why is that?
I don't want cops in my fucking house.
They'd only be looking at anything pertinent, like your daughter's room.
Can't you leave anything untouched? The way that it is? I don't want a single thing touched in that fucking room. Because that room's filled with nothing
but... It may be necessary.
Fuck that. It's full of nothing but memories. And things of hers. You're not touching hers. Have some respect for the dead.
That's exactly what we need to get in there.
You already probably, what, cut her apart?
She has a notebook, diary...
Checked her brain. Cut her fucking organs out and measured them. That's what you do in autopsies, ain't it?
You said a toxicology.
Can only provide us with so much.
Yeah. So my daughter had to sit on a cold metal fucking table, getting picked apart by some callous fucking mortician. And now you want to go into the last thing that I have, anyway, of semblance of hers, and that's her untouched fucking room, and you want to go tear it up trying to find evidence of what?
Anything that might be pertinent to the investigation, sir.
She was murdered outside of my house.
Okay. And we don't know who did it.
I thought he was going to do something with that statement.
Secret boyfriend that you didn't know about. Maybe something in a diary. Clues that could maybe allude to something else.
The last thing
one
that you are going
to
do.
Clues that I would think that a person like you wouldn't think to look into.
And what kind of person am I?
I don't strike you as a detective. What do you do for work?
What do I do for work?
Yeah.
Well, work down at the harbor.
Longshoreman?
Sure. Fishing, mostly.
Blue collar.
Fisherman.
I get it.
See, that could be a statement, though, the outside of the house, because it's a process of deduction.
You want us to bring the guy that killed your daughter down?
Yeah, I do, but I don't have anything for you, detective.
You don't know that.
Going through
her room, looking through things, we're not going to tear anything up, I assure you. They're very good at that. They're going to leave things where they belong. Nothing's going to be out of place. It's simply, they're going to try and look through and find any more leads that we can maybe look into and maybe even get a little closer to finding whoever did it to your daughter. And your wife and your daughter's friend.
No. I stand by what I said. I want my daughter's shit left alone. She didn't die in my house. She wasn't murdered in my house. She was murdered out there in the fucking streets. The streets that you guys are supposed to keep safe.
I'm afraid we'll have to file for a search warrant then on the property.
Right. Let's see if you have the probable cause.
Okay.
We'll see. You son of a bitch. Is there any other detectives that want to talk to me?
I don't know. Let's go find out.
We need to... I think the main thing we're missing still, Kowalski, is the fucking crazy part. The voices. Or, like I said, it also could be a deal to throw us off.
Well, he's got insomnia.
He also won't mention the voices.
Like sleep.
Yes, sleep paralysis.
Causes hallucinations, psychosis sometimes.
Yeah, dude, this is going to be part one, man. I'm not going to be able to finish up my storyline after this. This stream's been over 5 hours. We're definitely going to continue it tomorrow night. On tomorrow's
CC
stream.
CC me into the email.
He kills the wife. Allegedly kills the wife. She's just taped up and fine. I mean, lots of stab wounds, but... And then the alleged girlfriend or friend is also
beaten to death, I think.
Beaten to death, yeah.
Yeah.
But the daughter... Her hands are cut off. And her head...
Oh my god!
Oh shit!
Her hands got cut off. Fucking stealing medication.
I was thinking about fingering,
that's a good,
but okay. That works too.
Oh, ew. Ugh. Ugh. What the fuck's wrong with you,
fingering?
Right?
No, think about it.
Fingering? And that, like I said, you know, is there anything that you can think of at all that might be pertinent to the investigation? Anything
no,
that can help us?
There's not. And I've been in this station for fucking hours, dying in this hot ass, smelly interrogation.
Well, you're free to leave at any time. I told you, you're not being held here. You're here on your own volition.
Am I free to leave, though?
Of course. At any moment, you can get up and walk away. You don't have to answer any questions or make any statements whatsoever.
Chat, what should I do? Am I leaving or am I staying? You know what? Let me the fuck out of here. Let's go. I've had enough.
Thing.
Excuse me. Fucking cocksucker. Unlock the door, please.
Of course. There
Thank
you go.
You. Hey.
Yeah.
You don't have any family left, do you?
I have family left. Why?
Well, hopefully they don't wind up dead.
I would hope not.
He comes running out of the station and shoots me 19 times with a... No, they're gonna follow me for sure. No, they're gonna follow me for sure. Do you guys think I should go and ditch the gun? Or what do you think? I don't know what to do. I kind of want to log off so the end of this isn't rushed. But oh no, they're gonna follow me. But here's the thing. They gotta come all the way down here and I'm about to hit. Oh my god. Oh, that's them right there. Never mind. I was about to say I'm about to get loose on them, but... That's them right there, beige car. I can see the light, and I can see a little red light in the thing. I've done so much roleplay, dude. Just to shoot one of them. Nah, toss the gun. He saw me get up here, did he? Okay, he did. He did. They were stopping for smokes, but I know for a fact that cop's out there still. Yo, yo, what's up, child? That cop is still out there tailing me, huh? Where's that detective at? I was stressed. Yeah, no, dude, I'm stressed out, man. Just followed. Hey, thanks for the follow, but I got follow shit turned off because we're recording, but I got it on me, though, chat. Not mean to get my car stuck down there, that is for sure. I'm not gonna lie, I actually don't think they're in the area. I don't think those were detectives. I think that was just a regular black car. Yeah, I don't actually think those were detectives, if I'm being 100% honest. Oh no, they were. Never mind, I take it back. Yes, they were. Ah, bro, that guy's tailing me. Never seen this much tailing RP ever, not gonna lie. Yeah, they're doing it. I'm sorry, this is too amusing to me, bro. Having these detectives chase me. I hope they stop and try to talk to me or something, bro. I'll up chop on them and end them, bro. Nah, bro, they on me, bro. What if they're like four deep inside of that cop car, bro? I'm scared, bro. Yo! Get on the subway, jaywalking. I want to see if these cops hop out on me at all, bro. They're clearly tailing me. I just want to know if they hop out on me or not, bro.
It was the same car up the hill, bro.
Hey, yo.
Yo.
Be cool. There's an undercover cop car right around the corner. There's an undercover cop car right there. Don't do shit.
Why are you coming up here walking next to me, bro?
Don't worry about it. You see that car right there? I'm about to move on, but that car right there at that intersection, black one, that's a cop car. Detectives, just be careful.
But why are you coming to the vehicle?
No, bro, they fucking, they bumped into me, so it makes my gun fucking come out of my... You're looking out for them and they're still trying to be high powered? Yeah, well, I mean, what do you expect, bro? Lay on dick. Yeah, dude, this is looking sketchy. Jesus Christ. Pop this pussy. Nah, bro, this detective has been tailing me, bro. I'm a triple homicide suspect. I'm not gonna just shoot him. Yeah, look at the killer going back to the scene. I've revisited all the scenes, bro. Not what I meant? Oh, okay. Oh. Walk through it? Bridge. All right, everyone's saying bridge. You go down there, that's a one-way. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Props are still there, it would break immersion. Yeah, you know what, that's fair. Good point. Yeah, you can still see that detective all the way back there. There she is, dude. I'm getting scared, man. This would be the perfect place to corner me and just... No, it's such a waste. Okay, good. I will not get away, bro. I'm telling you, I will not get away. Damn, I can hear your gun bouncing. Yeah, it's in my pocket, for real. Bro, I won't get away. You guys are trying to get me caught. You know what? Fuck it. Here's what I'm gonna do. Here. Fine.
Perchance.
Yeah, no, perchance. No. You were one of the cops that interviewed me in the station. Yeah?
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So I thought you were gonna use the subway, but now you're standing here. Interesting. You know, you want to know something funny?
What's up?
Thank you.
Kuril Morks 22 redeem text to speech and says do a slash me of knocking her out and then a slash e slap.
Yeah, well.